Behind me, I have a 2009 Freightliner Cascadia with a DD15 engine, and I'm gonna show you how to use OTR diagnostics to reset your fault codes, reset your ash accumulator, and also perform a forced EPF regen. We're also gonna be checking fault codes and also live data using OTR diagnostics. So let's get started. The first thing you wanna do is just wanna turn the key on, engine off. The next thing you want to do is just open up the settings and make sure that the adapter is connected to your mobile device and where this is plugged into the diagnostic port while using the harness that we provided. Once the adapter is connected and we validated that in the settings, we're going to go ahead and open up OTR Diagnostics. Once the app is open, it's going to go through the full connection status where it's going to connect to your account, it's going to connect to your vehicle, and it's also going to initialize the advanced commands. Once you're on the dashboard, you're going to see the fault codes, live data, commands, vehicle information, history, and then we're also going to be changing the settings if you want to go through that process. But right now we're just going to go and view the fault codes. So we're going to go to view fault codes. Here it looks like there's a few fault codes here that are, one is going to be active and a few other inactive, but it doesn't look like there's any engine fault codes, so that's good. So we're just going to go ahead and view the live data. Here we have different live data, that data points that we pull with OTR Diagnostics that are able to see more information as far as intake manifold pressure, intake manifold temperature, oil pressure, oil temp, exhaust temperature, especially we're going to be tracking that while doing a forced EPF regen. So we're going to go ahead and do the forced regen right now with OTR Diagnostics. We're going to go ahead and make sure that the truck is running. So we're going to start the truck up. And in order for us to do forced EPF regen, we're going to go to commands. And it's going to start walking us through different things under commands. So we're going to go ahead and go to forced EPF regen. It just gives you some explanation about what this is. And then we're gonna go to hit confirm that we wanna do it. And then it says here the RPM may increase. It may take anywhere from 30 to 60 minutes to complete. So we're gonna go ahead and on the Freightliners, we're gonna have to do one extra procedure where you're gonna have to apply the parking brake, release the parking brake, take a few seconds in between there when you do that procedure. And then we're also gonna put the vehicle in gear, take it out of gear, to do that as well. So we're gonna go ahead and do that, those two-step procedure, and then we're gonna come back and start the forced EPF regen. Once you perform that procedure, on this one, we're just gonna click continue, and the last thing you wanna do is click start. Once we click start, it's gonna go ahead and do the forced EPF regen. Once it's doing the forced EPF regen, it's gonna take, again, 30 to 60 minutes to complete. After it completes, the idle's gonna come right back down, and you're gonna need to leave it running for at least 5 to 15 minutes to make sure that the whole system cools down after the regen. So we're gonna go ahead and click start, and right behind me, you're just gonna hear the truck idle up. And what it's doing is increasing the exhaust temperature in the DPF so it can burn off all the soot that's in there. And once it's going through this process, you're gonna start seeing smoke or anything coming out of your tailpipe. You wanna be tracking the live data to make sure that everything looks normal. So we're gonna go into live data, we're gonna see in here that we're gonna see the exhaust temperature. It's probably gonna be rising in here. So when you're viewing, doing a forced regen, you can track the live data to make sure that everything's working properly. The next thing you wanna do is you're also gonna be tracking the fault codes. You might get a fault code or two if there's an issue during forced regen, because when you're doing a forced regen, it's analyzing your whole after treatment system to make sure everything's working properly. What's nice with OTR Diagnostics, you also get the capability of resetting your ash accumulator. On this Freightliner with the EPA 7 engine, what you want to do with resetting ash accumulator is if you replace your DOC, your DPF filter on this truck, you're going to want to reset ash accumulator because that's the stored value in this truck's computers. And you have to reset that value or else the engine computer, your MCM and your CPC doesn't know that the replacement was completed. And you're going to want to make sure that you go through that process. If you're ever derated to where your truck just shuts off, because of SPN 3720, we do have a procedure with reset ash accumulated that will also reset that. So on this EPA 7 truck, it's really crucial that you have the right tools to perform diagnostics so you don't get stuck on the side of the road. We provide this with OTR Diagnostics. So we're gonna leave the truck running. And again, it's going to complete the forced EPF regen while using OTR Diagnostics. If you'd like to learn more about this, you can visit us at otrperformance.com for more information. Download the app, create your account to get started today. Thanks for watching.